Hi, Teddy Brevi here, and I'd like to thank you for joining us. And we do apologize, but because of the Easter and Passover holidays and lack of time for filming due to everybody wanting to spend time with their family, this is a slightly abridged version of our show. It's not what we usually do, but we do hope you find it informative and entertaining. We tell a couple stories and we give you a little information, so please enjoy, and we'll be back next week with a full-length program. Thanks. Hi, I'm Teddy Brevia, and this week on Mamakating News for the week of Wednesday, April 11th, 2012. We'll be doing updates on the Dwayne Thomas civil rights suit and the Flaum project on Schwanger Lodge Road. We'll be taking a look at the hidden costs of development and who really wins when you develop. We'll also be taking a look at the benefits of benefits and who benefits when you give out the benefits. All this in viewer response this week on Mamakating News. Hi, I'm Teddy Brevia, and welcome to the Wednesday, April 11th, 2012 edition of Mamakating News. As always, you can find us on Time Warner Cable Channel 23 at 7 p.m. on Wednesdays, or you can watch us on YouTube on the Mamakating News channel. You can also join the conversation on Facebook at Teddy Brevia Mamakating News. I'd like to thank everybody for the wonderful positive feedback we've been getting. It really is greatly appreciated, and we like to know that our work is getting noticed. In viewer feedback this week, our first statement comes from a question comes from somebody about the summer camp program, and that question was, why does the town board seem so focused on the park when our roads need so much work? With a 2% tax cap, shouldn't we be spending our precious dollars on road work rather than subsidized recreation programs? Where are the priorities? And our second response from a viewer was about the Dwayne Thomas civil rights suit. And that viewer asks, if the town was sued and the supervisor was sued personally, why doesn't the supervisor have to pay half the deductible or half of the settlement? And that's a question we'll be posing to the town board at the next town board meeting. Again, thank you for all the positive feedback. Keep the letters and calls coming. We're really happy to answer your questions, and we thank you very, very much for joining us. Enjoy the show. Well, the Flaum project on Schwanger Lodge Road, a hotel conference center, looks like it's back in the news. The project has been described as a someday project, but it looks like it's someday is now. Apparently, the Flaum Management Corporation will be submitting more technical drawings than they have in the past to the Town Planning Board, and will be on the agenda on the April 24th Town of Mamakating Planning Board meeting. Again, that meeting is April 24th, which is a Tuesday at 7 p.m. at the Mamakating Town Hall, should you be interested in going on down and seeing what's going on. In another update, the Dwayne Thomas civil rights suits are back in the news. After receiving information from at a town board meeting that the suit was settled and being told to FOIL for information, and having a FOIL request answered just last week that there was no information on it, I have received a copy of a check stating that Mr. Thomas has in fact been paid, and the check is dated on February 1st, 2012. Including the $5,000 deductible for the two suits, apparently for the two suits, I should say, a check for $45,000 was cut to Mr. Thomas. It's unclear if this is the total settlement or the settlement for just one of the suits, and we have put in calls to Mr. Thomas, Mr. Thomas's attorney, and the Mamakating Town Board members for comment. However, as of this point, none of them have decided to comment. We will be doing a really in-depth follow-up on this suit to see if we can get more information, because as the suit went on, all the information was shielded by executive session from the town. So the more details we get in the future, the more we'll let you know. If you grew up in the village of Wurtsboro, you know exactly where I'm standing, at Sally Kaufman's farm. Now all that's left of what was once a thriving farm where most people who grew up here worked as children. There's a couple of holes in the ground where the buildings were and a large pile of timbers that used to be a barn. This property is slated for the development of 72 townhomes. We also have the Raymond farm over the hill, which is slated for almost 400 what are called patio homes. And tonight we're going to talk a little bit about what the tax ramifications are if you live in the area. Development is one of the biggest local news stories that there is. And right now we're looking at some considerable development projects that are going to impact our town. In light of that, and the fact that we will be looking at a lot of development projects and their impacts, this is intended to be an educational portion of this show. We hope you learned something, and we're going to start it out with a film short from a series of film shorts called Teach the Town that were done last October. It's a short by developer Mort Sterobin, and it discusses how there are hidden impacts to the existing tax base when development occurs, in particular residential development. Mort, tell us quickly, who are you, and I want you to tell me a little bit about the hidden costs of residential development.
Well, I'm a resident of Mamakating for 62 years. I'm also a developer. I've developed up here, and I've developed in New York City. And as a developer, I can tell you that our goal is to develop, and the goal of the taxpayer is that hopefully our development is a positive for them. But in most cases, as studies will show, that for every new dollar that we collect from new residential development in a town of Mamakating, it costs the rest of us taxpayers between $1.40 and $1.50 year after year after year for that additional development. If we're building just a few homes, it's not an issue. But we have big open tracts of land. And one of the problems is with some of the loopholes that we have in our zoning, in areas that would allow only one house in 10 acres, if you take advantage of the loopholes, you can build 40 houses on that 10 acres. We've had applications in the past that have planned for over 700 homes. That would increase the number of homes in this town by 20%. If you increase it by that much, your taxes will probably increase also by 20%. And the other side of the coin is that if taxes go up, how are we going to attract industry here? How are we going to attract businesses here? And how are the people going to afford to live in their houses? Did you know that for people who have recently bought their homes, 40% of their mortgage payment now goes to real estate taxes? What's happened is we've turned ourselves in this town into renters. We need a new direction that will show us a different way to increase our tax base, at the same time not dwindling our quality of life here.
Now, on the surface, Mr. Sterobin's claims may seem a little bit fantastic, but some simple information really gives you a feel for how fast you can get in a lot of trouble, especially in regards to school taxes in our area. At the Raymond farm on Winterton Road, where the villages in Chestnut Ridge are proposed to be built, that project is almost 400 homes. And when you look at the fact that those children will go to the Pine Bush School District, and each child that goes to the Pine Bush School District costs $16,900 per year to educate, that extra dollar amount can add up very fast. And as you and I both know, there's very few, if any, houses in the town of Mamakating that pay a full $16,000 per child in property taxes and school taxes so that their children can go to school, and that leaves the rest of us to pick up the slack. Now, what you have to keep in mind is that all development is not created equal, and that commercial development will always help to mitigate some of the impacts of residential development. And you can't just look at residential development and say that it's a bad thing. You have to look at the total growth picture. However, for time's sake, we're only focusing on the residential here. In a future program, we will discuss the benefits of commercial and other kinds of development and non-development so that we can get a better look at our total tax picture and our total tax future in the town of Mamakating.